into unto. So one of the things that the Holy Ghost comes to do is to counsel you on what to do with your life. Because many of us believe that there is some basis somewhere influencing our progress. Many of us believe there is some traditional, occulting, demonic, bloodline, something preventing us from success, isn't it? And that bit improve that very belief. But you have the Holy Ghost who come to minister your needs in your heart, my son. Why don't you try this? Let me get to that beginning and try this one. And it's like, that it is your. Maybe that relationship is broken. Then comes that come. Because he knows all truth. He tells you. You see this girl? You love her. You see this boy? You love her. Move on with your life. That is what the Holy Ghost comes to do. I'm using this basic example because at our level, these are the petty problems you have. The kind of business to do, the kind of relationship to involve ourselves in, the kind of friends to work with, the kind of things we want to do. He is interested in those little life. I'm not under pressure to drive some kind of car. He comes to comfort me. How? By guiding me. He guides me into the truth. He says, that kind of business you want to do in 10 years, this is going to be your end result. Then you are relaxed. He takes you on a new path of journey. I see you listening to this man called Counselor in Jesus' name. Amen. Three, he is your advocate. He is your advocate. The word advocate means lawyer, the one who pleads your cause. As an advocate, he will help you. He knows how to plead your case, like the examples I gave earlier. He knows how to plead your case. It doesn't matter whether you are wrong. Invite him. He said, lawyer, take over now. He does the talking. You have been accused. I'm not a follower of this prophet that has been accused recently. But all through the accusation, he has kept quiet. He need not to explain himself to anyone. You see how the Holy Ghost is helping him? Keep quiet. I have not taken up the case. That's what the lawyer said, whether you are guilty or he comes to defend for you. He knows the kind of battle to place as far as the law is concerned. So you hear that somebody has committed some bono crime. There is pictorial evidence. There is video evidence. Year after sister, the person is walking freely. Why? A lawyer has argued the case for him. We have a great one. He's Jesus Christ. He said, you are not alone. I'm giving you the comforter. He will advocate for you. You see, when Christians understand this, you will not find issue with a fellow Christian who has wrong. Because he knows you will do wrong. He knows you will not do well. He knows things will not go well for you. He knows you will do, you will intentionally. This one is not unintentional. He knows you would intentionally commit a crime. When that happened, Holy Ghost, take over the case. He said, this case is beyond the Holy Ghost. That is why you are with me. So that you take care of beyond cases. Maybe this beyond means I cannot argue for myself. You can. I know someone who doesn't employ lawyers. He knows the laws himself. He knows how to write his case. He will defend his case. That means a person knows the Bible. He knows the law. But you don't know it. He knows it better. So in the realm of the spirit, you engage him. I see you engaging that advocate in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God.
Glory to God.
The fourth one is that he is your intercessor. Romans chapter 8, verse 26. He is your intercessor. This has to do with your prayer life. He is your intercessor. Paul is talking about the Holy Spirit, who will help you in prayer as he dwells inside of you. Romans 8, 26. Let me read from here. It says, likewise, the Spirit also helped our infirmities. So, the reason why you can't pray for more than 5 hours is because it is part of your infirmities. It is not a sin if you cannot pray for 30 minutes. Don't kill yourself because you heard some preacher say, a Christian, and you can't pray for 2 hours a day. You are joking. Come on. But I don't think you are preaching to me. What I know, as far as the Lord of God is concerned, is this. In fact, when we started, when I started being born again, myself and Pastor Mikey, my friend, is now at East Lagos. He's always praying. And I love him because I also need every prayer partner. So we will be praying morning, afternoon, evening, even night. We go to Achimota Forest. I remember that experience. We were praying fasting around 3. The weather has changed. And everybody was running because it's about to rain. But we refused to run because we felt like if the cause of the fasting and prayer, it rained and the rain beat us, the anointing has beaten our life. And do it, it rained. And you know the bad part of our worship, once we were praying, it was raining heavy. We were falling all down, and they said, the anointing has I will fall, he carry me, he will fall, I'll carry me. Have you seen knowledge? But as we were going, my desire to pray some prayers or to give long prayers was not forthcoming. I thought I was not sliding. The Holy Ghost opened my heart. As you know, we are 4 of us, 1, 2, 3, 4. All of us have been praying. I became a pastor. But along the line, hello, are you here?
Yes, sir.
Along the line, you want to become a businessman, but a Christian businessman. Different personalities in their field of calling. So the people are not allowed to choose what God wants them to do. So you see, I said, and I'm thinking myself, things are important. How many of us do meditation? What was the ultimate responsibility given to Joshua? Meditate on this book of the law. Meditate. Have you had time just to take like this scripture? It's just one scripture. Think about it. What is God trying to tell me? Oh, Jesus, help me to understand this word. To understand this word. Oh, Jesus, help me. Help me. Give me a shot of heart. Pray that it will come out. As the Holy Ghost will lead you, you come out. You begin to be like, oh, wow. Oh, I see. Oh, great. That is how He works. don't have strength, then you connect to the Holy Ghost. You will strengthen him. He will cause even your enemies to come and strengthen you. You see that phone there? During COVID-19, I needed a phone to do live stream on any platform. I don't have anybody to ask. But before COVID-19, I asked someone for coming. The person told me to take quite a long time. And in one of our chat, I said, my phone is in this spot. That was given way before. So he now asked me, what kind of phone will you use in the course of that? I said, everybody will say they are mad. But their mind cannot change the strength that the Holy Ghost can be. Finally, this morning, you went and slept in a food bar where your company was supplying food to people to eat. But ordinarily, you go and sleep there. But when it came, they said, come and sleep. You may not see it as a standby, but set. is stand by. So those little miracles are stabilizing. They are stabilizing you for the bigger miracles. Begin to appreciate the Holy Ghost in those areas. And bigger ones with time will come in Jesus' name. Amen. How many of you know that we've been drinking pipe water since God knows? Yes, sir. The good fridge, you know? When we have visitors, we say, oh, I want to just speak. Let me guess, sir. Just finish. Let me guess. Oh, no. Why are you going to far? You have come first, that water for you to drink. You came and brought me bars of water. Maybe in your mind, it's not just water. Because the man who brought that water for has been drinking pipe water sins. So is it in his mind? So whoever ministered to your heart, I told you something powerful. But maybe he might have not said it. Hey, my son, go and get water. But the water you are bringing is coming to change. The water is, you see, this one is pure, refined. That one, only God knows, it passes through many channels. Hallelujah. I see change coming away in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I see change coming in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Finally, he's your comforter. Your comforter. There's a song, I don't know that song, but I've heard it. He said, be still and know. Not be still and know that I am God. Not that one. When the ocean rides, I will be still and know that I am God. You see, he comes to comfort you when the ocean rises. He came to comfort you when tempest rise. He came to calm you down. He's like a father. When there's no food, you can't tell there's no food in the house. You go to that lady, there's no food. No food will be available. I'm getting food. You already know that dream doesn't have any amount of life. But he comes a tempest and he takes the pressure. That is what the comforter does. In the face of similarity, in the face of challenge, he tells you, take a few just rest tomorrow at this time. How have you connected to the comforter? I release the grace for you this morning that you allow him to comfort you. Maybe at times like this, they say you shouldn't miss that school. You don't have what to eat. He said, I will comfort you. He said, I will comfort you. You want to rise up on your feet now? Talk to me now. Help me to walk with you. 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 Help me. Talk to me. Just talk to me now from your heart. I want to help you. Be my strength and my intercessor, my standby, my comforter, my helper. Talk to me. Look, your times. I'm seeing Brother Jackson come to give me things that I'm saying in my heart. But if you know what they are doing, you may not. Some of you, there are some things you are doing. You can tell that some years back, you will not even think of them today. But if you look at the sacrifices the Holy Ghost led you to do, you can see practically that God is actually doing things in your life. I pray over your life this morning. I don't know whatever you're doing, but I see the Holy Ghost coming through for you. I see him coming to strengthen you. I see him standing by me. I see him ministering. Jesus. Before we close, I just want